What's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. I am back with another video. Let's get straight into this video. This video will be for my Cancer. This video will be for my Cancer, so let's get straight into it. If you are a returning subscriber, hey girl, hey. Hey boy, hey. If you are a new subscriber, welcome to the Vance Kingdom family. Let's get straight into this video. I cannot stand nosy ass people. I don't know where that's coming from, but I do not like when people be nosy. What the fuck is you being nosy for? Like, what the fuck? I just don't like when people don't mind their fucking business. Like, mind your fucking business. And what I'm saying or doing don't got nothing to do with you. What is you in my business for? You in my business? Don't do that. Don't do that. This video is for my Cancers. Please do not forget that this is a general reading. This is not a personal reading, okay? All right. So don't take it personal. If it don't apply, baby, let it fly, okay? This is highly requested from my Cancers. The freakiest of them all, water signs. I'm looking forward to the freaky energy. Like, what y'all bringing tonight? What y'all bringing tonight? Cancer. Y'all be with the shit. So we got our sage burn. We burn sage to release the rage. If you are a new subscriber, we have to get that negative energy out of the room, clear out space before we start getting into the reading. We're going to burn a chakra. This is the third eye chakra in the scent of jasmine. This chakra enhances your ability to focus on insight and visualization. When open, you will have improved intuition. Okay. Ooh. I like the scent of jasmine. That smells so good. Video for all my Cancers. Cancer 69 if you fine. Alright. Got one last thing to burn. Give me my meal. Thank you. Let's get into this reading. I'm about to close that window. It's kind of chilly up in here. A little chilly, really. Okay, so I definitely see you thinking about, should you look out for somebody? It could be somebody from your past, somebody that you dealt with for 5 years. I'm not sure this person is coming back to you for help. They're coming back and they need you. You knew they was coming back. You knew they was going to need you. This person is coming back asking for help after doing whatever they thought was green on the other side. Y'all know how they say the grass ain't green on the other side? Yeah. They back. Mm-hmm. And it's like, now you got to help this person out, because the only reason why you really helping them, Cancer, is because you love them, and because of the amount of years that you have dealt with them, and because of the amount of years that you've been in love with them. Also, Cancer, you could be an empath. You could be getting, you know, spiritual download, using your intuition. Like, I'm gonna help this person out, because if that was me and I came back to somebody that I was in love with, I don't want them to help me. So you more so coming from an aspect of, if that was me, I want somebody to help me. And you also still had love for this person. Like, yes, Two of Cups. Yep, definitely you still got love for this person. This could have been somebody that you really had a deep connection with. Give me some more messages for my Cancers. Could be dealing with the Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio. What this person had to offer when you guys did exchange cups of love, you could have had realness, honesty, you know, loyalty, all the great things in your cup. This person was playing games. This person was the type of person that like to offer you bullshit, offer you shit that ain't really worth nothing. When all along you was really offering this, and you had to cut this person out. This person could have offered, I mean, yeah, this person offered to put you in a third party situation. And not only did they offer, they did put you in a third party situation. And you wasn't going for that shit. The Magician, yeah, this person played a lot of games. This person played a lot of games. And now, the games that they played, because they played themselves, okay? Okay, they played themselves, so now they're forced to have to go back and backtrack. They're going to have to go back and re-step those steps. Because they did too much. They didn't step in the name of love. No, they did not. They like to play games. They thought they was on top. They thought that divine was gonna be on their side all the time. No. Spirit ain't gonna reward no bad behavior. No, they're not. King of Pentacles. So this person trying to come back with the offer, but you looking at this offer like, I got more than that, boo. And the only reason why you're actually looking out for this person is because of the amount of years, the amount of time that you have known this person, and because you and this person have been in love before. This person played a lot of games with you. This person lied a lot. This person was very childish, very immature. This person just... And every time you want to leave, they always come back with some bullshit. Playing games. Like, they really want to be in a relationship with you when... No. Sir, give me some messages. 7 of Wands. So, you could be defensive in regards to their offer. Like, first of all, what you're not about to do is play no play. You're not about to bullshit me again, nigga. I already know your bullshit. I can call you out of your bullshit. Ain't no need. Ain't no need, baby. Ain't no need. Ain't no need for you to be trying to come up over here. You know, you could have battled a lot of people. You could have gotten into a lot of people over this person. This person have caused you to lose money, caused you to lose jobs. Yeah, a lot of lies and deception, the moon card. Because this person's played a lot of motherfucking games. The four of swords. Excuse me, I got these right here. This person played a lot of fucking games. And right now they trying to figure out why they can't come back in the same way that they used to be able to come back. Why things ain't working the way it used to be working. Baby, I'm not doing no talking, I'm thinking. You could be thinking right now, Cancer, like, you just in your head about a lot of shit. Thinking about your emotions, thinking about how this person made you feel after they lied and deceived you. Like I said, you could be there with the Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio. You know, it ain't like you don't want to be there for them, but you thinking about the way that this person made you feel emotionally. Like, that's where you stuck at. You had to have a lot of strength in order to move forward from this situation because, in all honesty, you really thought this person was the one, but they motherfucker played so many games. You got to see that, no, baby. I'm playing myself. Yeah, Queen of Swords. I'm not playing with you. Very cutthroat. Very straightforward. Listen, if you want to come correct, come the fuck correct. So, with the Ace of Pentacles, this person could have got granted with a wish. Spirit could have given them what they wanted, but took it back from them because they wasn't humble. Yeah, the Star card, a wish fulfillment. This person fucked up their own money, basically. And now they want to cry over spilled milk. This person could have married somebody, could have married the wrong person. This person could have been moving slow. Then one minute they want to move fast. This person never came correct because this person was still trapped in their head, trapped in their thoughts, was stingy, hiding shit. Act like they was working, they was focused on their money when they was giving to two people. Like, no, baby, this person was very indecisive. This person was blinded by whatever they chose to be blinded by, but we gonna figure that out. Let me see if Spirit got any more messages before we get into this, okay? This person was sneaky, though. Very, very sneaky. Played a lot of games. Didn't I say this person moved... The Chariot, this person moves slow, but they want to move in fast. When they see you pulling your energy back, and then they want to act like they're going to cut you off. King of Swords. Oh, now all of a sudden they want to act like they're going to cut you off. Baby, you're a page. Sit down. You don't have much to offer. So even if you did cut me off, I ain't going to be motherfucking stressing over you. You will come back to me. This person is, I don't want to say retarded, but this person got a mental illness. Some way, somehow. Let's get some Spirit and Oracle cards. This person, like, literally, what they had to offer was something that was like a dead end. Like, the shit was going to end sooner than later. Because this motherfucker played too many games. Acting like they had money, they had no money. I'm gonna get straight to it. This person acted like they was very abundant and was not fucking abundant. Had you going up against a lot of people because this motherfucker wanna lie and deceive you. This person wanna drag you in a situation instead of just keeping it real. Now that this motherfucker need help, they need help coming in from my help with this Five of Pentacles energy. They need help now because they all fucked up. Karma is a bitch. When you do some shit to people, the universe got his way of sending your ass down. So now that this person trying to come back after they lied and deceived you and just took you through some of the bullshit, unnecessary bullshit, you're not really as lenient. You're not really as open. Yes, you do have love for this person. Yes, this person could confide in you or talk to you because what this person did didn't change you, but you're not really the same person as you was before. Like, this person can't do the same shit that they was doing. Like, you more so on some, nigga, I will cut you off quicker than the fuck I let you back in type shit. This person is coming back towards you because this person has lost a lot of things, and karma is taking a play in this situation, because when you do wrong to people, especially people who are divinely guided, especially how do I say it? Earth angels, especially people who you do wrong, who are earth angels, spirit got a way of taking exactly what they gave you back, slowly but surely. This person is moving fast in a tacky way. This person don't know how to communicate. This person is very reckless with the things that they say, how they communicate. This person is very emotional. They like to move too fast. Magic works through you. You have Scarab, Beetle Spirit, magic works through you. So you don't want this. You don't gotta have it, baby. It's all up to you. The abundant universe will provide. Nothing gets wasted. So you may have felt like you wasted time on this person because the way that this person dogged you out, and the way that they treated you. But guess what? The fact that they came back, nothing was wasted. They wouldn't have came back if it was a waste of time. They wouldn't have came back if you wasn't nothing, if you wasn't on their mind. They knew who to run back to. They knew who would help them. That's why they came back. They knew. Take time out. You need to take time out for yourself and to rethink this situation, which I definitely see reassessing the situation, because you're not really talking. You're only thinking about your emotion in the way that this person made you feel. So you definitely take a time out to reassess the situation. Even though this person is somebody that you love and somebody that you had history with, Spirit wants you to reclaim your power, okay? Don't get too caught up in what they got going on to the point where you forget how this motherfucker did you. Manifest what you want. The universe will provide you with what you want, but you need to take the time out to pray, to manifest, to ask for the stuff that you want. You need to take time out for yourself. If you ain't feeling this, you ain't feeling this. You ain't got to fake the phone. If you don't want to take this person back, you don't got to, but it's not going to be for everybody. We got more than one Cancer out there. But this is for someone who will be open to listening to what this person got to say. You knew that this person was going to be back. Y'all could have been in a battle for about 5 years. Co-create with spirit. So, you're needed to bring your ideas to life. Whatever ideas that you have, talk to spirit about it first and get clarification. Like, ask for it. Is this okay to do? Should I be doing this? Is this something that I should be reinvesting in? Spirit, give me one more card. Like, you could have made a lot of mistakes with this person, okay? But with this vulture spirit, you could have made a lot of mistakes with this person, but you are definitely learning from the mistakes, and nothing is wasted. The mistakes that you learn from this person, like I said, you're not gonna just take this person back easily because of what you've been through. I already told you that. Time for beginning mind. So you may want to start over with this person, but you don't really know how to start over with this person. And I definitely see you trying to reclaim your power, but you're gonna have to magic work through you. You can reclaim your power. Don't get me wrong, but you're gonna have to co-create with spirit first and just let them be your guide. Just ask them if you should be doing this for more clarification. Now is the lucky time to do that. Especially when you see this person all over the place, they come back. Let me close this window. Very defensive with this person, but you can't really stop it. Like, you can be defensive, but only for so long, if that makes sense. Like, had this person not played games with you, lied to you, tried to get over on you, and you know, mistreat you, thinking they could do shit, like, somebody got spiritual gifts themselves. So they thought they was gonna get away with something, baby. You're not. They did not. They cannot. You got your own spirit angels and spirit guides, and you got an intuition because you're an empath. Somebody is also clairaudient. Somebody is clairaudient. How do you say that? But I definitely see you got into it with a lot of people. This would be friends or family in regards to this person. And for this person to come back, it's like, I didn't got into it with all these people because of you. Now you trying to come to fuck back. What you trying to do, fuck up some more shit? You done already fucked up enough stuff. I don't need you coming back fucking up more shit when you already in your queen energy. Queen of Swords, okay? You already where you need to be, doing what you need to do. And here he come. Or here she come. I'm telling you, with this Mercury retrograde, we got things coming back from the past now, because there's cycles that we also need to complete. So that could be the case, but we're going to see. So we're going to get some raw cards, but we got two deck of raw cards. So, excuse me. Did you yarn too? We got these, the blackjack. We got these deck of raw cards. And then we got these. So, I'm gonna pull some of these first, and then we gonna get down even more specific, okay? Get into this shuffle. Even though the cards are already pre-shuffled, it don't hurt to do a little bit more. Obstacles. So you could have went through a lot of things with this person. Like I said, this person could have put you in a lot of bullshit. They want to come back and they want to cater to you. Exposure, emotions. So spirit is saying, you know, they want to cater to you, but you need to let this person know exactly, excuse me, how they made you feel. 444 is significant to someone. You could be saying an angel meeting at 444. Your emotions could be up and down because you do love this person, but based off of them lying and deceiving you and putting you in a whole lot of bullshit, it's hard for you to, yeah, this person, they want to take you to dinner. Like, they gonna be trying. Ooh. Look at my tongue. This person do not want me to talk. How could I hurt and betray someone so beautiful? So, they're starting to understand that the stuff that they put you through was unnecessary. Just for them to what? Come back? So what the fuck are you, like, what you do that for? Unless something is meant to be wrong with you, because the stuff that they put you through was so unnecessary. They didn't have to do you the way that they did you. Grandmother, somebody's grandmother could be significant in this reading. Answer the phone. And then it says betrayal. So, and then you also have, how could I hurt and betray someone so beautiful? So this person knows that they betrayed you. You know, they may be trying to reach out to you and call you guys. May not be in contact right now, but this person needs you. This person, okay, stripper, okay. That could be significant to someone. Let's get some more. Let me shuffle these first. Opposite. So you guys could be opposites. Cancer, you may feel like this person does not understand you. Like, you guys like different things. You may like to eat healthy. This person like to eat trashy or like eat crazy stuff. You may be calm, cool, and collected. This person may be loud and rowdy. You may like a clean house. This person may be messy. Like, you guys are opposites. Let me give you the angel wing is 555. Transformation and change. Transformation, change, and exciting news is on the way. Let's see, any more messages before we move on? You have a hard time being yourself. And I think this is how you feel in regards to this person, because this person plays a lot of games. Like, this person acts like a chameleon. When they get around certain people, they like to act like they are the people that they're around. So say this person is around your family members who, okay, not even your family members. Say they're around people that cook. All of a sudden, they got a whole bunch of insight on how to cook, knowing they don't even cook at home. Say they're around drug dealers. All of a sudden, they know how to drug and deal. Baby, what? You don't even do that on your own time. Like, this person like to camouflage. This person does not know how to be themselves. Whoever they get around, that's who they become. Like, this person has a personality issue. It says, I helped you on your time of need. So you could have really looked out for this person. Or this person could have, with you having a battle with a lot of people, this person could have put you in a position where, with your friend, somebody's friend is a stripper that you helped, or vice versa. It says clear your mind. And when I say vice versa, you helped this person who's a stripper, and then I don't know if it was this person who you was dealing with end up messing with them or what. Something like that. Your love is unique. That's why they feel like, how could I betray you? Why would I do that for you? Why would I do that to you? And you feel like it's very personal. Whatever happened with this stripper, you could be a stripper. Shoot, I don't know. I want to lick you up and down. So they trying to use sexual energy to get back with you. They are thinking about marriage. But the only reason why they thinking about marriage is because it's like a controlling mechanism. Because, yeah, like I said, controlling mechanism. They thinking about marriage because they would never get you back. Like, their emotions are up and down. So they want to use sex as a way to get back to you. They want to lick you up and down. It says, let me ease your mind and lick your pearl. Oh, wow. Exactly. Spirit wants you to continue to be strong, stand your ground. This person has ego problems, so they're going to react out of their ego and fear. Because they know that you guys are opposites. They know that they did you wrong. They know they have a hard time being themselves, and they're scared. They're scared to lose you. You have, I didn't follow my heart, and I regret it. That's, look. They know your love is unique. It says, October energy. October Scorpio energy. I'm sorry. Low-key, this person was envious of you. What did I say? Didn't I say this person ain't retarded, but they had an intuition? I literally said that. This type of person has feelings for everybody. I'm not with them for love, only the money. Okay. So that could be dealing with this stripper person. If they cheated with you, if they cheated on you for somebody that you are friends with, a stripper lady that you help, and they end up fucking. Spirit wants you to continue to be strong, like I said. Spirit, any more messages before I move on? Yeah, this person is really gonna be trying to get you back, okay? They worry they will never get you back, so they're gonna be trying to use sex, you know, their emotions up and down. They don't even really want to marry you. Their emotions just up and down. They don't want to lose you. And you hitting them with this, baby. I can read you like a book. You ain't coming over here with the bullshit. Let's be clear. Okay? Let's be clear here. So we're going to get some of these blackjack cards. These cards. Got maybe these tell stories, okay? We're gonna get down to the scenario, the overnight scenario. Don't forget to hit that like button, comment down below. Show your girl some love. Now, due to these cards being very, very huge, we got to shuffle like this. Because I can't, my hands, I got no man hands. So I can't get it like that without bending it. So I don't really want to bend my cards. So we're going to do them like this because I want my cards to stay straight. I don't want them bend. Baby, we need what we need, Spirit. Come on. We don't need no whole deck of cards coming out now. Spirit, give me some messages in regards to my Cancer tarot reading. Spirit came through and took this connection down on purpose because it was not built. Oh, okay. Thank you. They said slow down. Spirit came through and tore this connection down on purpose because it was built on lies and a false foundation. Like, this person played a lot of games. I told you that in the beginning. This person was lying, doing all kinds of crazy, weird-ass shit when all they had to do was keep it the fuck real. Like, you wasn't going to take their head off or beat them like they stole something that they want to be in a relationship. But now you might want to because, nigga, you saving me. Like, bitch, I'm not the fuck paying me. I cannot describe what I'm feeling when it comes to you. So I'm kind of picking up, this is how this person is feeling towards you. How could I hurt and betray someone so beautiful and they feel like they betrayed you and all of that? So it's fucking with their mind. Now that they even got to come back to you. The person that they betrayed, they got to come back to. Not you, Cancer, but this person is fucking dumb. They not dumb or retarded. They just got this. Baby, they got this. You know when it's time to release a situation, you are fully aware. So that's what you, Cancer. You know when it's time to walk away and when this person, like, you know, that's why you in this, where is that? That's why you're in this four swords energy. No talking. Just a lot of thinking, you know, and thinking about the situation where it's happened and about your emotions. You know when it's time to release the situation. You just trying to allow all your ducks up in a row. You just looking at it for what this person is telling you and what you already know. You taking it for what it is. But you won't hit this person now because of the amount of love that you have for this person. You ain't no heartless ass motherfucker. It ain't like you don't care about this person. And whether this person get it together to be with you or anybody else, you still want them do good, but you are fully aware when it's time to, nah, I can't deal with this. Oh, like this person is really thinking about how can I betray someone so beautiful. Okay, so it says, this person is thinking about when you guys first met. They remember, they're remembering the good and bad times you guys shared. They are thinking about reconciliation. I'm telling you, this person's emotions is up and down. It says, there's painful things I've experienced in my life that I don't want to talk about. I shut down. And I believe this is your energy, Cancer. That's why you're taking this shit with a grain of salt. And you really, like, you're really not even talking. You just not releasing how you feel. You're not really showing no emotions. You're just thinking about the way you feel. Because you have experienced a lot with this person to the point where it caused you to shut down. Because this person has played too many games. This person did too much. Like, this person's full of ego. This person is very egotistical. They love to manipulate and control. You're being put in this situation because you're strong enough to realize and see through their bullshit. Cancer. Exactly. Like I said, you ain't really sweating this person. You're fully aware of the situation, how to release it. But you gonna sit there and listen. You won't hear what they got to say, because baby, you left just to come right back. So I need to hear this. Let me know. What that visual? What he do? Oh, okay, cool. Oh, you back? Okay. Y'all funny. Give me some more messages in regards. It's so weird how the shuffle these cards, they're so big. But give me some messages in regards to my Cancers. It says, I am terrified to take you back after you cheated on me. I acted like it wasn't a big deal and it really broke me. I was in love with you, that's why it hurts. So like I said, Cancer, you know, you cannot describe the way you feel when it comes to this person. You know, you really do love this person. But after all the lies and deception, just rewind. Because I told you, after all the lies and deception that this person did, you're fully aware on if you want to help this person out. And I think you are going to help them out off of the strength of humanity, off of the strength of being humble, off of the strength of kindness, off of the strength of this person being weak right now and needing somebody. And despite what they did to you, you still got love for this person. But you can't take them back on a relationship level, because what they did to you, it would never be the same for you, because of how they fucking doled you out. Like, it would never be the same. It says, I don't take you seriously. They want you badly. They think that you guys are meant to be. So this person does want you deeply, but you can't take this person seriously. Like, I don't care if they think y'all meant to be or not. You have a hard time with taking this person seriously. Oh. This person is toxic. This person was a burden. Yeah, and once you release this person, you start gaining momentum. You start getting abundance. You start living your life. You know, you may be single. You may not actually be in a no whole loving relationship, but shit, you wasn't in the type of relationship you was with in before. And you would risk your life for this person. You know, you would do all that you have to do for them at that time, but they fucked that money up. This person is lacking self-confidence. This person is very insecure, okay? And it says, Spirit is trying to humble this person. This person is very arrogant. This person is very arrogant, boastful. This person treats others like they're beneath them when they are on top. So this person could have really, you know, when they got money or when they had cars, clothes, whatever they had that made them feel like they was the one, they treated you like shit or treated you like you wasn't there. You know, entertaining other females, lying to you, deceiving you. Oh, you know, they just got a brand new car. All of a sudden, they ain't coming in the house no more. They doing this. Okay, cool. Do you. Okay, so more messages. Don't compare yourself to anybody. Everybody has their own journey and their own challenges. Stop working against yourself. Your time is coming. So that's basically saying, like, don't go back to this person. I don't want to really advise nobody because I don't want you to be like, well, the Vast Kingdom said don't go back, and then I don't want to be all up in that. But you need to know that everybody does have their own challenges and their own journey. So don't work against yourself by taking this person back because you got a kind heart. It's okay to look out for somebody but not fully be invested in the situation. So don't fuck up what you got going on because of the amount of love that you have for this person or because you care about this person. Trust future you to deal with future problems. Go with the flow. Nothing yet is set in stone. Don't panic. So this is not going to last. So don't think that it's going to fuck up your future. It says trust future you to deal with future problems. Go with the flow. So just go with the flow and know that everybody has challenges. And I think that you already know that. That's why you don't mind looking out for this person, because you know that this person is weak right now. But don't stop working on yourself. Don't give up on what you have going on and, you know, focus too much on this person, which will be working against yourself, because you got to keep that. Keep you going. You got to keep doing what you're doing. This person's coming back to you, not, you know what I'm saying? They come back to you. Don't forget you for them and start focusing more on them than you. No, we're not doing that. Okay? You came too far now. You don't understand why their life is going so bad. It's because they are wishing bad on you when you already passed your test. So this is why the fuck they can't get nothing up and rolling and going and manifest nothing, because they so busy wishing bad on you after you done dropped them like it's hot or whatever you did to move on from this person. And Spirit got a way of working in mysterious ways. You could wish bad on somebody. Guess what that's going to do? Especially somebody who, like you, Cancer, divinely protected. Guess what it's going to do? So it's just like this. Okay. I'm sending this like this. Let me show you. Let me give you a perfect example. Tap, tap, tap. Yeah. So look. So you can blow this way. And guess what it's going to do? This smoke is still going to drift back this way. You throwing smoke that way and the smoke going to come back that way, baby. You ain't doing nothing but hurting yourself, trying to hurt me. Boy, sit down. They can't understand why shit getting fucked up for them. Had they not did you wrong, shit wouldn't be going wrong in their goddamn life. Period. This person could have put you through physical abuse, emotional abuse, in the home. So you could have lived with this person. They could have physically or emotionally abused you. Let's get some Lovers Oracle cards. And then we're going to get some Lesson Journey cards. And I'm going to let y'all go because, baby, this reading is pushing up into an hour. I've been holding this down on my own. And no, I never ever cheated. I never lied. So you can stop asking me why I never left you, and why I kept it real, and why I'm still with you. You should have known better than to think I would leave. And I'm picking up, this is your energy, Cancer. Matter if you're up, matter if you're down. Either way, I'm gonna be around. But they can't use you no more. You gonna be there for them, but they should have known better. The only reason why you gonna look out, Cancer, is because you got a kind heart and you want somebody to do the same thing for you. Close your eyes and tell yourself that you deserve to feel joyful. You can allow joy into your life regardless of the circumstances you currently find yourself in. So find humor in this. Laugh at this motherfucker. Laugh at the situation. The fact that they betrayed you and they trying to come back and they need you. This person betrayed you, but they got to come back and ask you for help. The same very motherfucker that told you you wasn't shit. Coming and asking you for shit. Where you got that way of humbling motherfuckers, okay? When you pass from this world, you take nothing with you but your soul and the memories you have shared with those you love. That's why you don't come from an evil place. That's why you don't come from a cold-hearted place, because, like I said, you may genuinely still love this person. You may not be in love with them, but you genuinely love them. So that's not going to take away from your kindness or who you are. You're not going to stop being who you are because this person hurt you, or this person put you in fucked up circumstances, and, you know, this person only gave you fucked up memories. You still care about this person, even though they did that. Somebody out there do. I don't know. Comment down below if this your motherfucking reading. Okay? But it says, don't rush into it. Allow nature to take its course. Yo, wait a second. Oh, hold up. Because it said, look at this. Hold on. Look at that. Why I try to find this card. Because it said, go with the flow. Okay. Trying to find the card that said go with the flow. They are playing games today. Where is that card? Hold on, y'all. Let me put this down. I know I saw it unless I'm looking in the wrong card. I can't be. I gotta show y'all. Like, definitely go with the flow. Okay. Let me go slow. Told you. Okay, so it says, don't rush into allow nature to take its course. This card says, trust future you to deal with future problems. Go with the flow. Nothing yet is set in stone. Don't panic. So, let nature take its course. Let it. Let me get y'all some lesson journey cards. You call me. my Soul Journey lesson cards. So this is the lesson that you're supposed to learn within the situation. Honesty and abundance. Okay, so we're going to read honesty first. I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it from myself. So yeah, be honest with this motherfucker. You ain't got to take them back, but you can. You listen, you kill a motherfucker with kindness, okay? I'm a limitless being, and I can manifest what I desire in the physical reality. And if this is not the type of person you want, you can manifest who you want and be very abundant. That's for some of you guys to discipline. I can accomplish what I set my mind to without fear. Without fear. You can accomplish what you set your mind to without fear. Indecision. I use my intuition in all aspects of life. And I told you, somebody is like, somebody got fucking, I want to say psychic powers. I want to say psychic powers, but somebody is like an empath or clairaudient, something where you can pick up on shit. Self-esteem. This person, I'm telling you, they had a definitely low self-esteem. I possess gifts of the soul that benefit me and others. You show this person by loving yourself and standing up for yourself that that's what you need to be doing. I don't know why you're sitting there playing yourself. Wow. Doubts. I release the need to know all the answers. What do we say? Guess what? Trust future you to deal with future problems. Go with the flow. Nothing yet is being wasted, so don't panic. Don't panic. It's your turn, baby. You still trying to win. It's your time. Okay, so that was your reading, Cancer. Y'all want some chocolate oracle cards? I mean, they ain't oracle, but they chocolate cards. Alright, let me get y'all something. Alright, they gave you more. Okay. Calm it down, Megan. Thank you, Megan. So, I am a mentor, not a rescuer. Right on motherfucking time. You will teach this motherfucker a lesson. And this is how you teach a person a lesson. By being humble and kind and saying what's on your mind. Okay? You're not going to be trying to be their mom or dad or parent them. But you're going to let this motherfucker know what life is all about. You're going to show them how you live life the right way and not in a cowardly way. Not in no bitch nigga way. Like, I need you to stand. Real nigga, stand up. Real bitch, stand up. Okay, thank you. I avoid continually sacrificing my own happiness for others. By rescuing and enabling them, as doing this may hinder my personal growth for both of us. I choose not to be a martyr. I am a mentor, not a rescuer. I do not assume that everyone wants my opinions and solutions to their life challenges. Didn't I say everybody go through their own life challenges and journeys? Wow. And if I am in doubt, I will ask them. I take responsibility for my own happiness. You know what? Girl, I probably didn't read that in the best way, but babe, you can read that for yourself. Screenshot that. Okay. Read that. Okay, so that was your reading. I hope that you guys enjoyed this reading. Don't forget to hit that like button. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you can stay notified anytime a girl like me do upload new content, okay? I hope this really resonated with somebody out there. This is a general reading, so if it doesn't apply, baby, let it fly, baby, okay? This is not gonna resonate with all my cancers. We got about a million cancers in the world. Not all y'all going through the same shit. Some of y'all been there, done that. Some of y'all are just approaching. Some of you guys are going through this. But listen, if this is your reading, comment down below and let a girl know. And don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. Oh.